Zion and all family.
Yes, amen.
Thanks be to God. As a song, just got to sing because of the blood of Jesus.
Yeah.
That makes us family.
Amen.
Yeah, and you know, and as things start saying that godly man standing up in an ungodly era. Certainly, that's what the world needs. More godly men.
Yeah.
But thanks be to God. Thanks be to God and through Jesus Christ that He made this possible. I can be the first one to admit that I have not always been on the Lord's side. The Bible tells us that there is none righteous.
Right. Yes.
Not even one. And even all of our righteousness is like the other rags.
Right.
So the thanks be to the blood that Jesus shed on Calvary, paying for the sins of the world.
Right, man.
I don't know about you, but like I said, I've been loving you. Say it all your life, but I like Paul said, I was wretched.
Yes.
Undone.
Right.
You didn't know me. When I was out there in the world, I was one that was against the things of the Lord. Mm-hmm. But because of the blood and my trust in the Lord, and I have discovered and know now that I'm happy all the day long. And that's why the scripture tells us, rejoice in the Lord. Always. We're not going to hold you long, but I don't want to return to our scripture here. I think you've already read Psalms 1. It says, again, blessed is the man who comes who walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, standing in the way of sinners, nor sitting in the seat of the scornful. You know, that's just right there. That's enough right there that we all rejoice in. Blessed, happy is the man. Even if it's just one man, that's a blessing. Otherwise, even if it was one man that was on this earth that committed sin, Jesus would have died. That's why he came. To pay the penalty for our sin. For the Bible teaches us and said that the wages of sin is death.
That's right.
But the gift of God is the eternal life. And that's why we ought to be rejoiced that we don't have to die and go to hell, because I know beyond a shadow of a doubt that where I was headed. But I thanks again to the Lord that He has turned me away from the things of the world. But we want to, so I don't need you, I get it. But there is a scripture that comes to my mind that the Bible teaches me, teaching all of us that, again, that Hosea the prophet said that we are destroyed because of the lack of knowledge.
Amen.
We have not always had the knowledge of how God has been good, He's been to all of us. And let me throw this in while it's on my mind, is that certainly let us keep praying for South Florida.
Amen.
Because that could have been our children and your children and our grandchildren. But thanks be to God that He's still sitting on the throne.
Yes, sir.
He's still in control. He And without him coming, all of us were doomed to hell.
Yes, sir.
But now that he has shed his blood on Calvary, and as the scripture says that this blessed is a man who walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. You know, pastor scripture shows me about the two roads that all of us follow. Can't go down one road at a time. Either you we're on the Lord's side or we're on Satan's side.
Yeah.
I think Pastor Richard told us this morning, we can't be afraid of the devil and be afraid of God.
Amen.
So we either want to be on one side or the other.
Yes.
So we need to stand up and let the world know what side that we are on. You don't have to wear a cross around your neck.
Right about
it. Saying that you're on the Lord's side, but because people are looking at all of us.
Yes, right.
Looking at all of us, and our lifestyle dictates whose side that we are on.
Amen.
And the Bible tells us also that be consistent.
Yeah.
God that I serve and you serve, he always did things and still does things always decent and in order.
That's right.
We are the one that are what our order because we have strayed away from the Lord, but the Lord is steadily trying to get us back to him.
Man.
And he was there, and the Bible teaches us also that Jesus Christ himself, he was the same yesterday, today, forevermore. But can we say that?
Right.
So I want to encourage us people to take the word of God, like he said, that we need to be more consistent. That's a word that I heard on yesterday.
That's right.
We are up and down just like the stock market. But if we be consistent, just like Jesus was,
right.
And so that means that we're going to have to stay where on the battlefield for the Lord.
Man.
And so when we stay on the battlefield for the Lord, and then one of these days, when it's time for him to call us, and he can say, well done. Thy good and what faithful servant, thy and faithful. Over a few things, come on up. I'll make you ruler over many. But let me say just one last thing before I can sit down. That just like Joshua said, in the Old Testament, God gives us choices.
Mm-hmm.
He's not going to make us, we're not robots to where we will even make us do anything.
All right.
Because we have choices. Either we are on the Lord's side or we are not.
Right.
And I heard Joshua say when he got ready to leave, he said, choose this day.
Yes, sir.
Whom you're going to serve.
Yeah.
Are you going to serve God on the other side of the river, or are you going to serve the God that we know now?
Amen.
But I heard him say last fall, he said that as far as me and mine.
All right.
We're going to serve the Lord.
Yes, sir. Yes.
We're going to serve the Lord day in and day out.
Right.
Amen.
No matter what the world says, the Lord is on our side. And he promised us that he would never leave us nor forsake us.
Amen.
Now I heard David say that I once was young.
Yes.
Now I'm old, but I've never seen the righteous forsaken.
Yes, sir.
Not only that, I've never seen you see begging for bread.
Mm-hmm.
that he provided a way for all of us, both men and women, to what?